where, in fact, Drew McIntyre did not win the WWE title. But we'll talk about that here in just a moment.
Yeah, I think other bookers would be excoriated for this one. I mean, I'm not, you know.
I'm ready to excoriate for it.
Yeah, I mean, to me, it's like I knew there was two finishes. Either Drew wins or Punk costs him the match, and they did one of them. So it's not, you know, I mean, the thing with it is that Punk and Drew can be a big feud without the title. So it's fine. I mean, it would be a bigger feud with the title. I didn't have like strong feelings, you know, because I knew that there were two different ways to go. So it's not. But I think that the thing that I'm very negative about, so I would say I have somewhat strong feelings, is that they shouldn't have done the same finish twice in a row, basically, to Drew at Clash in the Castle. Both times, you know, one in Scotland and the other in Wales, you know, which is close to Scotland. And, you know, they had everyone. So, I mean, in that sense, I would be negative on the finish. Because, again, and Drew and Punk, I mean, they can be for the title, too. You know, it's not like that's a shame to do that. So, you know, it's a way to build heat. But, yeah, they basically did the same finishes 2 years ago. And I don't know.
I think the biggest thing is that, yes, they screwed him in Wales. And then if you watch WrestleMania and you're a fan of Drew McIntyre, it's
they'd already done this finish.
Well, they screwed him out of the title after he won, did the cash-in. But I think when he won the title at WrestleMania and then got screwed out of it by CM Punk, I think everybody immediately was thinking, well, you know, they're going to do Clash of the Castle in Scotland. If you're a fan of Drew McIntyre in Scotland, you bought your ticket, presuming that's where he's going to win the title. And the big thing to me is, you know, finish, whatever the finish is, the reaction with people loudly chanting bullshit and Samantha Irvin telling people to please drive safe and they boo the hell out of her because they're pissed off at the finish. I don't like finishes like that where people are like that kind of pissed off, where they're like angry that they paid their ticket price and got screwed out of it when they fully were expecting something to happen. And it could have happened. There was no reason Drew couldn't have won the title and done Drew and CM Punk for the title. I mean, there's no reason you couldn't have done that.
No, you're absolutely right. There's no reason. It's actually you know, if you want the championship to be the biggest thing possible, that is the biggest championship match you could do right now.
Yes.
Of any match for any title. I mean, Cody Rhodes doesn't have, you know, Cody Rhodes and Solo is not as big. I mean, Cody Rhodes and Dwayne's bigger, but that didn't happen until Mania. You could argue Cody Rhodes and Roman's bigger, maybe, but that's not happening right away either. So, I think that the other thing too, you know, which you bring up is that, like, nobody promises you a championship change, but they jacked up those prices. You know, I mean, it was the last I looked, I know when they first went on sale, the lowest price was $419. The last I looked, the lowest price was $316 because they were, you know, they didn't sell all the tickets, and ticket prices are, what's the word they use? They vary, you know, that's not the word, but it's, you know, it's like if the tickets aren't sold, they drop them a little bit to sell tickets. It's how tickets are done now. And, but the demand was like, I mean, I looked at the secondary market demand. It's in the Observer. I mean, it was freaking gigantic. There's almost nothing left on the secondary market. So they, you know, those people paid a lot of money, and they were expecting a title change. And to do that when it was the finish that they already did at Mania, and they had already screwed him. But, you know, again, when I was looking at the card and I'm going like, you know, what are they going to do? I said, there's two possibilities, you know, didn't know which one they'd go with. And they went with one of them, you know, and I thought, you know, like they're going to go and say Punk and Drew doesn't need a championship, and then we can also have a championship match. But yeah, charging those tickets, going to Glasgow, the same deal as Cardiff, the same deal as WrestleMania. You know, I could see fans being mad at the repeated finish. I mean, this is what I could see fans being mad at. But you know, the way that they do their business, it's like they're not going to go back to Glasgow for a long time. And when they do, you know, they'll have much lower prices. And I think that they're also at the thing where it's like, you know, they're going to come back. You know, they always do, which is, you know, I mean, that's a great thing to have, to be, have your company so hot that you can basically give them anything you want and they're going to come back. And if they don't, you know, I mean, I've seen that happen too. You know, I mean, you know, Road Warriors not beating Tully and Arn in Chicago, and, you know, WCW could never sell out Chicago again, you know, until, you know, years and years later. I mean, they pissed people off, and that was an automatic sellout city. So this stuff happens, and but it's not a, you know, it's not a monthly business. So they felt that they could do what they could do, and they're riding high. But I would say, like I said, like I think that I think most bookers would be excoriated for this one. Yeah, for doing this again. Yeah.
Well, the main event was Damian Priest and Drew McIntyre. And the story here is that we had a near tragedy where Priest ends up doing... He's going to do the move where you run, vault off the middle rope to do the flip dive to the outside. And he goes running, and he puts that foot on the middle rope, and his foot slips, but he keeps going over the top rope. And he gets his foot caught between the top and the middle rope, and he ends up hanging upside down by only his ankle. Like, his legs splay apart, and I can't believe it, like, tear his groin. And he's just hanging there. And so Drew McIntyre, you know, his leg, he kind of gets hit in the head with the leg as Priest goes over. So he kind of takes a bump, but then he looks up, he sees a guy hanging there, and, like, he just panics. He, like, stands up to try to help the guy get out, but then he kind of realizes, you know.
The problem was, is in a situation like this, the idea is the ref's supposed to do it. And the ref was fucking doing it as much as he could. And he wasn't strong enough, I guess.
Well, before that even happens, Drew looks at the guy and he kind of panics. And then he starts kicking him because he doesn't know what else to do because the guy's stuck.
Yeah,
so he starts kicking him a little bit. And then the ref is trying to get Priest out, but the ref can't get him out. And so now Drew gets on the apron, and Drew starts helping the referee get Priest untangled. And Drew turns to the crowd, and he screams, "Well, I can't win the title if the guy's in the ropes." So he was at least thinking what's logical. Like, I'm helping my friend here, but I got to explain it in wrestling sense. And the sense is, I can't beat him if he's hanging upside down. So he gets him out.
I thought that was pretty good thinking on your feet.
It was. So he gets...
Because him extricating him the way he did, you know, I mean, like, if you're in the middle of a match, a grudge match, you know what I mean? If it's a normal match, it's one thing. But in the middle of a grudge match, to do that generally would make no sense. He needed that explanation, I think.
So
he thought on his feet and came up with it.
So he gets the guy out, and you can see that Priest is hurting. But he just keeps working the match, and he's doing all the spots that involve running. He does all the spots that involve kicking, but he's limping and he's hurting. And he said after the show, I think he said his foot felt like garbage. I forget the term that he used.
I think his knee felt thrashed. Maybe?
He's got to go get it examined. Right now, they don't know I mean, he did the press conference before even getting looked at. So we could get good news. We could get bad news. But we don't have any news yet, and probably won't until
I actually heard from them, and the preliminary news wasn't bad. They were actually saying it's like a miracle, but that's not, you know, that could change Monday, you know. But
yes.
It wasn't as bad as they feared, but it's still, you know, it's not, nothing is conclusive. It's not like, oh, you know, like, you know, he needs surgery. Can't say that. We can't say that he's fine. We don't know. But I do know that as time went on, from what I understand, it was there was a hope, you know, kind of a hope that he's okay. But, you know, I mean, there's like, it's funny because as this is going on, it's like, okay, he's supposed to win. Okay, we know that. But if his knee is blown out, which it could have been very easily, or, you know, ankle or whatever, right? His ankle or groin or whatever it is. You know, I mean, look, they were very strong on the way they were doing that finish. Well, they had punked there and they weren't going to reconsider, you know, they were doing what they were going to do. They thought that was the right thing to do. And it was a situation where right in the middle of the match, there was something there that was almost like, maybe we should call an audible because the guy's hurt. And the only what's going to happen with the audible is that everyone's going to love the show. You know what I mean? But they didn't do that.
Well, what happened was Drew hits a claymore and Priest kicks out. And then the referee gets bumped to the outside. So he's on the floor. Drew hits another claymore, covers. There's no referee. So all of a sudden, this referee comes.
Covers for 10 seconds.
You see this referee flying down the aisle, and he flies into the ring. You only see from behind. You can only see the guy's feet. And you see the guy count one, two, and then he just stops. And the crowd starts screaming. And it turns out that this is not a referee. It is CM Punk in a referee shirt. And Drew looks at this guy, and he's going to kill this dude. And he starts bullying him in the corner. And he's going to choke him to death. And all of a sudden, Priest grabs him from behind, hits South of Heaven. The first referee returns and counts the pin.
You missed the big thing is Punk low kicked
him low. Oh, he kicked him low, yes.
Kicked him low very, very hard, which set up the chokeslam finish.
But the point is, the fans booed Punk like crazy, which you would expect. And
They did and they didn't. I mean, they did. Yeah, they did. But, you know, when he was leaving, Punk is such a celebrity.
Well, of course, if he stands by, fans are going to hug him. They're not going to attack the guy.
Yeah, yeah. But, I mean, he's saying, look, they don't hate me, you know, like that. I mean, it was almost like, hey, I'm the bad guy, but the people still like me. I mean, it was very interesting how he did that. You know, and there were people chanting CM Punk and stuff, too, you know. But, you know, yeah, he's the heel, of course, because it's Glasgow. But I think that, you know, the idea is worldwide. Even though he's a total heel, he gives the guy a low blow. He, you know, McIntyre had the match won clean. Total heel. But the way, you know, it's structured, you know, it's like Punk is supposed to be the babyface coming out of this. And, you know, I don't think they're going to go like, oh, Drew's the uncrowned champion or anything like that. I don't think he's turning, nor do I think he should turn. But,
well, honest to God, when I watched it, it was like there's either two options here. It was a double turn. Or they're doing the deal where they figure that CM Punk in America is going to be considered a hero for screwing Drew McIntyre in Scotland. And we're going to find out on Monday. Actually, we won't find out on Monday because Punk said he's got to go get evaluated. And he claimed at the press conference he would not be at Raw, but he hoped to be on SmackDown announcing that he was cleared. So we'll see what happens on Monday.
Yeah. Oh, cleared? That's pretty quick. That would mean that they could do the match at SummerSlam.
Yeah. They could.
You know, I suppose they could even do it in Toronto, you know, if he's cleared this week, you know. I always thought that SummerSlam was the best if he could get cleared by then. And it's pretty quick. So, you know, I mean, usually 6 to 8 months. I mean, end of January. So early August is 6 months. You can make that date. Mid-July? I mean, look, I mean, it's not out of the, you know, it's not incomprehensible that he gets, it's interesting though, yeah.
Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and click that notify button and you'll never miss a video again.